we have the prophetic word more fully confirmed, to which you will do well to pay attention as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Knowing this first of all, that no prophecy of Scripture comes from someone's own interpretation. For no prophecy was ever produced by the will of man, but men spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit. Pope Francis opened the 75th Extraordinary General Assembly of the Italian Bishops' Conference on November 22. His Holiness greeted the prelates with a card containing an image of the Good Shepherd. In the pictorial cross of Pope Francis is an image of Jesus Christ depicted as the Good Shepherd with his flock. The image is accompanied by text of a reflection entitled, The Beatitudes of the Bishop.
The seventh of the eight Beatitudes states, Blessed is the Bishop that works for peace, who accompanies the paths of reconciliation, who sows in the heart of the presbyterate the seed of communion, who accompanies the divided society on the pathway of reconciliation, who takes by hand every man and every woman of goodwill in order to build fraternity. God will recognize him as his son.
The Bible is the Word of God. The theme of Psalm 46 is the greatness of God and His power to deliver us from things that are beyond our abilities. God is ready to help us in the present moment, and we can place our trust in Him. He wants people to understand that it doesn't matter what we face in life. God is greater. The greater the things we face in life, the less we can deal with them. We are too tough to stop fighting in our strength and allow God to take His rightful place as Savior and Deliverer. Blasphem, chapter 46, verse 10.
In this documentary, we share with you the thoughts, experiences, and dreams of two secular Carmelites known by the moniker Ortega Twins of La Union, Maria Luz Bolong, the Academic Dean of the Cienskai College, and Maria Nila Arhel, our communication instructor. These two women are taking this courageous act of letting the people know of the personal fruitfulness and achievements of the Marcos administration in their lives. They too want to accept the challenge of accompanying our divided nation on the pathway of reconciliation, for they believe it is Christ-like. The father of the twins was appointed by then-President Ferdinand E. Marcos. They are proud of their father, and it could be gleaned from the letter of Executive Judge Artemio C. Macalino to their Mama Rose on January 28, 1974.
I will read a portion of that letter. He was one of the best district judges that we in the car have been privileged to have. Since his appointment as district judge of our Azamis branch in 1968, up to his demise in 1973, he has consistently been one of the top 10 district judges of court with the most number of cases disposed. I, although belatedly and photomously commend our late district judge, the Honorable Evaristo Ortega, for a job indeed well done. No less deserving of this commendation are you, your children, and the others whom he left behind, who inspired him into dedicating himself to the service of his people and country.
In 1974, the twins graduated at the Pontifical University of Santo Tomas with a degree in communications arts. Right after graduation, they worked at the National Media Production Center, NMPC. A government-owned media agency was founded in 1965 during the Marcos regime. It was located at Intramuros, Manila. The minister at the time was the late Gregorio Sendana. The twins were assigned at the television department. Then, Luz was transferred in the movies department, joining a location shooting at Cagayan de Oro. She experienced her first exciting and memorable airplane ride. The birth of the Home Development Mutual Fund, HDMF, more popularly known as the Pag-ibig Fund, on 11th of June 1978, provides an affordable shelter financing. In 1981, Mila and her husband Pacifico Argel availed of Pag-ibig loan and built their own house. The house became a home of both of them and their three sons, PJ, Resty, and Neil.
DIMSU was created by former President Ferdinand Marcos by using Presidential Decree 1778 to combine a number of state-run schools in La Union into a single state college in 1981. The twins studied at Don Mariano Marcos Memorial State University, Mid La Union campus. They are graduates of school year 1995 to 1996. The Philippine Heart Center was established through Presidential Decree No. 673, issued by President Ferdinand Marcos in 1975. On October 7, 2021, the Feast of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary, Nila's twin Luz attends Mass at the Philippine Heart Center's chapel. At the closing song, their brother Steve informed Luz that the operation of Nila was a success. On October 15, 2011, Luz left Nila at the Philippine Heart Center to be at the Carmel of the Holy Family Chapel for the Feast of Saint Teresa of Avila. Luz shared her reflection on Saint Teresa's feast day. This is an excerpt of her message.
Her twin Nila's new life at 57 after undergoing heart bypass surgery last October 7, the Feast of Our Lady of Holy Rosary, is a welcome relief. It is for this reason that I offer this piece of message to help Nila be bold and fearless in this critical time to her life and in sharing our dreams. And what could be the dream? Like Saint Teresa, a great woman whose feast we honor today. May Nila and all of us present here remember that we, too, are born for God and God alone.
The San Juanico Bridge is said to be the longest bridge in the Philippines. The bridge is also known as a symbol of love by Warainans, which connects the sister islands of Samar and Leyte. It is a gift of Ferdinand Marcos to his spouse Imelda, who is a native of Leyte province. The twins had a photo at the San Juanico Bridge when they visited Tacloban during the one-month anniversary of Yolanda Typhoon. The Cebu Cordova Link Expressway, a project under the Build, Build, Build program, is one of the Duterte administration's ambitious infrastructure development. Indeed, since 2016, DPWH Secretary Mark Villar has worked hard to bring about a golden age of infrastructure for the Philippines. The twins were happy to have their photo taken when they were at Cebu for the opening of the 500 years of Christianity in March 2021. Cultural Center of the Philippines Complex, conceived in 1966, is an 88-hectare reclaimed property owned by the Cultural Center of the Philippines located along Rojas Boulevard in Metro Manila. It is a mixed-use cultural and tourism hub overlooking Manila Bay in south-central Manila, most of which fall under the jurisdiction of the city of Pasay. After more than a decade of performances abroad, the twins watched the award-winning musical Miss Saigon starring Lea Salonga at the Cultural Center of the Philippines.
The Fourth World Meeting of Families was held on January 22-26, 2003 at the Philippine International Convention Center, located in the Cultural Center of the Philippines complex. We were excited to get the nihil obstat of Monsignor Thaddeus F. Mercado and imprimatur of the late Archbishop Edmundo M. Abaya, D.D., of the Archdiocese of Nueva Segovia, Ilocos Sur. Archbishop Abaya permitted us to distribute copies of our book entitled Like a Child on Its Father's Lap, A Twin's Encounter with God the Father, to the local and foreign delegates. For the first time, we proudly put our moniker Ortega Twins on a sticker as a gift from us.
Issuance of Presidential Decree Number 1616, creating the Intramuros Administration for the purposes of restoring and administering the development of Intramuros. With this decree, major cultural landmarks were preserved, developed, and administered for the perpetuation of Filipino heritage and the enhancement of our national identity. Through the invitation of the late Senior Pilar Versosa, a cousin of Nila's husband Chikoy, the twins attended the first festival of twins held at Intramuros, Manila in 2004. Senior Versosa, founder of Pro-Life Philippines, sponsored the event. Natalie Palanca was the driving force behind Festival of Twins, who has twin granddaughters. President Ferdinand E. Marcos signed Proclamation Number 1081 on September 21, 1972 at 7:15 p.m. On September 23, 1972, President Ferdinand E. Marcos announced on television that he had placed the entirety of the Philippines under martial law. The late President Ferdinand Marcos should be credited for the peaceful departure with his family from the Philippines 35 years ago. To avoid what could have been a military confrontation in Manila between pro- and anti-Marcos troops, Marcos was advised by U.S. President and Senator Paul Laxalt to cut and cut cleanly. Marcos then fled with his family to Hawaii.
Before we proceed, watch us in a jingle dance entitled A Tandem for a United Philippines, together with Mona Lisa Gonzalez, Jeremiah Pilado, Floyd Clarice Alde, Angela Leigh Salvador, Aravel Galima, Alan Sendel Maglaya, Jordan Kima Pilado, and yours truly, Jocelyn Valdez.
I am today announcing my intention to run for the presidency of the Philippines.
Si Bongbong at Sara ay pinagtambal. May isang layunin at yun ay magkaisa. Halina at dating iboto na.
Bigla na lang nag-click ang tandem nila. Di ko inasahan na ganun resulta. Legit na panalo Bongbong at Sara na to. BBM at Sara ibubuto ko. Wala nang tatalo dito. Ang number one sa puso ng buong masa, ang tandem na ito. BBM at Sara, BBM at Sara,
BBM at Sara. In closing, let me quote Romans chapter 14 verse 12 states, "Every one of us shall give account of himself to God. Therefore, let us stop passing judgment on one another. Instead, make up your mind not to put any stumbling block or obstacle in your brother's way. There should be no cause for hostility between pro and anti-Marcos, as we are part of the same spiritual family. We are all sinners. No Christian can brag about their goodness, since we are all saved by the same kindness of God. Forgiveness brings a kind of peace that helps you go on with life. Let us stop filing disqualification cases against Bongbong and allow him to run as president. We believe he is prepared to lead the country due to his intelligence and heart to serve." The humble words of his running mate Sara Duterte is worth pondering. Sometimes in our lives, we need to stand behind another leader. I confidently believe that the experience of Bongbong as governor, congressman, and senator will help him to do his job as the president of the Philippines. We have prepared the presentation to bear testimony on the importance of doing the right things and staying on course, so we can say with Saint Paul, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith.